Welcome to a video that will discuss more properties of trigonometric functions. The goals of the video are to determine the domain and range of the trig functions, and also to determine the sine of the trig functions in each quadrant. Remember, you can think of the domain of a function as the inputs and the range as the function's output. For trigonometric functions, the inputs are angle measures and the outputs are ratios of the sides of right triangles. So let's begin by considering the sine and cosine functions. To me, the easiest way would be to analyze the graph, not on the unit circle, but on the x and y coordinate plane. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. Let's right now focus only on these first two graphs of sine and cosine. Essentially, what you're going to see here is as this point animates around the unit circle, it'll plot the function values on the x and y axis as we see here. Now this is in radians, but in degrees it would be from 0 to 360 degrees. Let's see what we find. Again, just look at cosine and sine for right now. So if you look at these two graphs, you can see that if we continued around the circle again, the graph would just continue. Or if we went clockwise or for negative angles, we would go backwards. So this graph will go left and right forever. So the domain would be all reals. However, we can see that the range, the high points and the low points, the lowest point is -1 and the highest point is +1. So that would be our range from -1 to +1. So the domain for both sine and cosine would be all reals. But the range, we have a minimum of -1 and a maximum of +1. Now let's take a look at cosecant and secant. Now here it's going to be a little more involved because if you remember that cosecant theta is equal to r over y, cosecant is not going to be defined when y is equal to 0. And when we look at secant theta, secant is not going to be defined when x is equal to 0. So let's take a look at cosecant first. When would y equal 0? Well, y would equal 0 here and here on the unit circle. So what angles would those represent? Well, it would be any multiple of 180 degrees. So what we can say for the domain is that theta, such that theta cannot equal 180n, or some multiple of 180, where n is some integer z. And we'll come back to the range. Let's take a look at the domain for secant. The same issue now, except now x can't be 0. And x would be 0 here at 90 degrees and at 270, or 90 plus or minus any multiple of 180. So we can state that as theta, such that theta cannot equal 90 plus any multiple of 180, or n would be some integer. Now let's go back to that unit circle and look at the graphs of cosecant and secant. Here's secant and here's cosecant. So you can see there are vertical asymptotes, and for secant they occur at 90 degrees plus any multiple of 180, and for cosecant they occur at 0, 180, and so on. Now the range, however, you can see there's going to be two intervals. It's going to be 1 or larger, and -1 or below. So we're going to have 1 to infinity and -1 to negative infinity for the range. And that's true for both. So negative infinity to -1 and from 1 to infinity. And this is true for both. Okay, we've got two more to talk about. Let's talk about tangent theta and cotangent theta. And again, what we're going to notice that tan theta is not going to be defined when x is equal to 0, and cotangent theta is not defined when y is equal to 0. So we should be able to figure out the domain for tangent. Again, x would be 0 here and here, so 90 plus any multiple of 180. So theta, such that theta cannot equal 90 plus 180n, where n is some integer. And for cotangent, y would be 0 at 0, 180, and any multiple. And let's go ahead and analyze the graph again, looking at tangent and cotangent. Tangent and cotangent occur here in the bottom left-hand corner. And again, we can see the vertical asymptotes, which we already identified for tangent and for cotangent when y is equal to 0 on the unit circle. If we just look at one piece of the graph, it does go up forever and down forever for both graphs, so our range would be all reals. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at determining the sine of the trig functions in each quadrant. Now, on the left here, you see the definitions of the trig functions in terms of x, y's, and r's. This can be very helpful in determining which are positive in which quadrant, because we know that in the first quadrant, x and y are both positive. In the second, x is negative, y is positive, and so on. And we know that r is always positive. So the first thing, the first quadrant's easiest. If x and y are positive, they will all be positive. In the second quadrant, anything involving x would be negative. So looking at the left here, cosine theta, secant theta, tangent theta, and cotangent theta all involve an x, therefore they will all be negative in the second quadrant. Sine and cosecant will be positive. In the third quadrant, both the x and the y coordinates are negative, so anything involving an x or a y would be negative unless it involved both an x and a y. So if you take a look at tangent theta and cotangent theta, we'd have a negative divided by a negative. These two will remain positive. All these others only involve an x or a y, therefore these will all be negative. Remember, r is always positive. And lastly, in the fourth quadrant, x is positive and y is negative. So if x is positive, so cosine and secant are positive. Let's go ahead and mark those off. Since y is negative, these two would be negative, sine and cosecant. And lastly, tangent and cotangent involve one x and one y, so they'll be negative. So this kind of explains why each of these are positive, negative in each quadrant. There are some acronyms out there that can be helpful in remembering these, but I like to think of it in terms of why they are. But for example, A, S, T, C has been used, and it stands for all students take calculus. A meaning all of these trig functions are positive. In the second, S meaning sine and its reciprocal are positive, the rest are negative. In the third, tangent and its reciprocal are positive, the rest are negative, and C for cosine and its reciprocal being positive and the rest negative. You could also think of this as the word acts, A-C-T-S. This was more of a definition video, but hopefully you found it helpful. Thank you and have a good day.